luck to you.
Thanks.
Good run. Good save.
Minutes anyway.
Hey, I got your call on that Ironman.
Save yourself. There's evil in the garden.
happiness coming and going. I watch you look up and watch my feet are growing. I know just who I am. And how many corners do I have to turn? How many times do I have to learn? All the love I have is in my mind. I hope you understand.
Well, so much stuff. I'm letting all the fast guys go.
Let them go. Let them go.
And I'm going to back down because even just behind Jeff in one buggy, we got into some stuff and triple arrows straight down, a hard right hand turn right out of a fence. Kids are cutting jumps already in there and stuff. We come over. Operational, we're both good to go. Headed over to tech inspection next. These things squared away by score. So we can race. I keep saying, you know, the Ironman thing is really, really nuts, but we can see doing it on a bike, but doing it on a quad, that's crazy. These quads are so punishing compared to bikes. But, you know, it's a little nuts, but it's just about going slow enough to stay strong. Finish it.
Thank you. just popped out of Hamu back on the highway, heading toward Borrego, and it's 11. So we know you passed in front of us, so we're just going to go around to the next pit, and we'll see you in Borrego. All right, bud? Good luck. We went over there. We didn't see him. And when I checked him online, he was already past the checkpoint. You're saying, Kathy's saying that John's still back there at 105. Satellite phones are awesome. Are they saying John's still sitting over there? All right, we're gonna have to go back then. We went to that spot. Well, we'll start heading back that way and see if we can find him. Okay? Thanks, Cord.
We're at mile 200. He's at mile 180, but he's only running along about 22 miles an hour. So we don't know if he's running out of flat or he's still in the rocks on the pass. We're getting the tires ready in case he has a flat. He can ride it in from there.
Yeah.
So he blew a fuse on his bike.
Oh, that's why.
So that's why his GPS is f***ed. He's in Borrego right now.
Borrego?
He's in Borrego at the Mag 7 pit, which is right about when we thought he'd be there at 2. And they're fixing his thing. He'll be down there for 5 or 10 minutes. Then he's heading to Valley T. He thinks it probably would take him 2 hours to get to Valley T. So I said, hey, we may or may not get there when you're there. So he goes, hey, if you get there, get the air filter out, we'll change it out. If not, I'm just gonna keep going. And then just stick with the plan and head back to the finish.
Mag 7 couldn't bend it back very much. I'm already done on fuel and food. We're kicking ass. Kicking ass! Robbie Gordon and Collins blew right by me the second I turned into the pit. You guys missed. Fighting trophy trucks left and right.
Yeah.
Last I heard, you were second in class, John.
What?
Second in class. Only 3 or 4 A's have gone by.
Are you freaking kidding me?
No. That's only the last I heard. I know that's the best.
Oh, look at, oh man. I got to Borrego 30 minutes early. I would have been 45, 50 minutes early. I stopped and helped 3 riders. One guy wanted a ride.
Awesome, awesome, awesome.
You're doing great, man. Just keep it up.
Awesome. All right, guys, this way.
All right, buddy. Keep it up.
All right. I'll see you guys either on the road or at the end, huh?
Good luck.
Thanks.
Good luck. Good luck.
Be safe. Be safe.
To the world I know, faith lost long ago.